नमस्ते दोस्तों, मेरा नाम सी राजेंद्र अरोड़ा है। और दोस्तों, हम जानते हैं कि 31st जीएसटी काउंसिल मीटिंग में बहुत सारे रेट ऑफ टैक्स के चेंजेस प्रपोज हुए। नाउ नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन अराइजेज इन दिस लाइन इज दैट व्हेन दैट पर्टिकुलर रेट ऑफ चेंज इन रेट ऑफ टैक्स शेल बी एप्लीकेबल एंड ऑन विच टाइप ऑफ सप्लाईज विच आर बीन मेड। Now we have to determine that whether old rate till when on what transactions old rate shall be applicable and on what transactions new rate of tax which is going to happen very soon shall be applicable. For this particular solution, law has provided us a section, section 14. It talks about change in rate of tax in respect of supply of goods or services. Now friends, we all know that earlier in service tax regime there used to be a point of tax, and point of tax used to determine that when actual supply or service or sale is happened. Similarly, in GST law also there are two sections which are talking about time of supply, section 12, and time of supply of goods, section 12, and time of supply of services, section 13. Now this time of supply triggers or determines the point of tax at which that particular supply becomes taxable, or that transaction becomes supply and then becomes taxable. In order to determine which type of tax or what tax, what rate of tax is applicable, we have to determine the time of supply. Section 14 talking about that in case there is a change in rate of tax, then the following provisions shall apply to determine the rate of tax to be applicable. It starts with notwithstanding anything contained in section 12 and section 13. So it means section 12 and 13, section 14 is overriding section 12 and 13 in order to determine the time of supply in case when there is a change in rate of tax. Now the entire section is being divided into two segments. One, when there is a goods supply of goods or services which has happened before the date of rate of change, and another segment when supply of goods or services happened after the date of rate of change. So first segment is goods have been supplied before or services have been supplied before the date of rate of change. Now there are three basic events which have to happen in order to determine the time of supply. One is goods have been supplied, services have been supplied, invoice issued, and date of receipt of payment. Now these three events or these three steps have to be taken into consideration to determine the actual time of supply for various transactions. Now first type of segment is goods or services have been supplied before the date of change of rate in tax. Now if invoice and payment both have been received before the date of rate of change, then the time of supply shall be the date of receipt, date of invoice or date of receipt of payment, whichever is earlier. Now whatever date is determined, that shall be the time of supply, and if it happens to be the before the date of rate of change, then the old rate shall apply. If time of supply happens to be before the date of rate of change in tax, then the old rate shall apply. If time of supply happens to be after the date of rate of change, then the new rate shall apply, my dear friends. Now second situation, invoice has been issued prior to the date of rate of change and payment has been received after the date of change of rate of tax, then the time of supply shall be the date of issue of invoice, my dear friends. Third situation, payment received prior but invoice issued after the rate of change, then the time of supply shall be the date of receipt of payment. All these three situations have been discussed. Time of supply if happens to be the prior to the date of rate of change and the old rate, and time of supply if happens to be the after the date of rate of change, then new rate shall apply. Second segment in this section, when goods or services have been supplied after the date of rate of change. Now another three instances, when payment received after but invoice issued prior. So two events have happened after, then the date of receipt of payment shall be the time of supply. Second situation, where invoice issued prior, receipt is also prior to the date of rate of change, then the time of supply shall be the date of receipt or issue of invoice, whichever is earlier. Third situation, invoice issued after but payment received before the date of rate of change, then supply is also after, invoice is issued also after, then the time of supply shall be the date of issue of invoice. And where the time of supply is after the date of rate of change, new rate of tax is applied. Now, my dear friends, you all can determine the time of supply. The moment you determine the time of supply, you will come to know which rate, old rate or new rate, shall apply. In this section only, two helps are being provided. In order to determine the date of receipt of payment, a proviso is being added. It says the date of receipt of payment is date of credit in the bank account of the supplier. But this date of credit should be at least after 4 working days from the date of rate of change. Let's take an example. For example, rate change happens on 4th January this time. And the payment hits into the bank account of the supplier on 5th January itself. Now, 4 working days are not being lapsed. So, the receipt of payment shall not be considered after the date of rate of change. If it happens on 10th January, then 4 working days have been passed. Then, in that case, it shall be considered as the date of receipt after the rate of change. Another explanation with respect to date of receipt is added. Date of receipt shall be considered earlier of two events, when the date of receipt has been booked into the books of accounts of the supplier or amount has been credited in the bank account of the supplier. Whichever is earlier, that is date of receipt. My dear friends, I hope that this will be useful for you to determine which rate, whether old or new, shall be applicable on your goods or services or on your supplies. Please keep watching our YouTube channel. Thank you very much. Please subscribe our YouTube channel. Thank you for watching this video. Thank you.